So about 3 or 4 months ago, I made a video talking about the reasons why I decided to go with the DJI Mavic Air over the DJI Mavic 2 Pro. Now at the end of that video, I said, let me know in the comments if you think I've absolutely fluffed it. And yeah, mate, I absolutely fluffed it. People, the rumors are true. I absolutely fluffed it when it came to buying my new drone for 2019. Now, I made an entire video talking about why I decided to get the DJI Mavic Air over the Mavic 2 Pro, and my God, I was literally so wrong. I think it's really important to actually address when you get things wrong, especially when you're making videos about things and talking about how good they are, when really I hadn't have even used it. In a real life situation, I was just looking at the specs going, yeah, this is sick. This is going to be perfect for me. I don't need to be going out spending 1,400 quid on one of these bad boys. I could have just got the DJI Mavic Air for super cheap. It's tiny. I can travel with it anywhere. But then when I actually compared the two, this thing literally destroyed it in every single avenue. And I was actually sitting there thinking, hold on, mate, what am I doing? What am I doing with this drone? So I'm going to break down all of the reasons why I decided to invest in the Mavic 2 Pro over the Mavic Air. Long story short, I was out in Sri Lanka with my boy Mikey V, and we're both flying our drones at sunrise, mate. God, it's beautiful. The sun's just about to come up over the Sigiriya Rock, and we're laughing, mate. This is looking decent. Anyway, we get both of our drones up. Mike's obviously got the DJI Mavic 2 Pro, thinking he's a bit of an hard nutter. He ain't. And I'm sitting there with my DJI Mavic Air thinking, yeah, mate, this is going to be sick. I don't need no DJI Mavic 2 Pro. None of that, mate. Too expensive, too big. Just don't need the issues. We both get the drones up and we both fly off into the distance. Next thing I know, I go 200 meters away. Lost connection. Hold your horses. Where's my drone? It's just lost connection and it's only 200 meters away. I can still see it, but for some reason, the rubbish transmission that is done by Wi-Fi on the controller's just gone, nah, mate. Don't want to know. I don't want to send you an image no more. I'm going. So I'm like, hold on a sec. This is absolutely rubbish. And Mike is standing there with his Mavic 2 Pro. He's at least like 400 meters away and he's solid as a rock with his transmission, mate. Now, you lot know me. I will not go out and buy something excessively expensive just for the sake of it actually looking better. All that I really care about is, have I got the tools to tell my story the best way that I can possibly tell it? And I originally thought that the DJI Mavic Air could have done that. But nah. Hold on, it can't even go 250 meters away because it's got Wi-Fi transmission in the controller compared to this bad boy that has actually just got the original RC transmission. I don't know what it is. I'm not a scientist, but this thing is solid as a rock, mate. And if I can't even get my drone 200 meters away from where I'm flying it, I'm more than likely not going to be able to get my shot. Therefore, I can't tell the story I'm trying to tell. So yeah, first reason, the transmission, mate. No good. And on this thing, solid as a rock. Just so sick. Other than the transmission, the biggest thing for me that sets this drone apart from the Mavic Air is the fact that you can actually change your aperture. Now, I typically like to shoot my drone at either sunrise or sunset, and the lighting conditions change very, very quickly. Before the sun actually rises, it's really dark, and then when it actually peaks over the horizon, the scene is really bright. Therefore, usually I have to bring my drone in, change the ND filter, send it back out, bring it back again, change the ND filter, and that wastes so much time. After using this thing, I was up in the sky, sunrise, for like 20 minutes without even having to change an ND filter. I could literally whack on ND16, these here, yeah, no, hold on, these. Polar Pro ND filters are literally the ones, mate. Like, I will not be sending my drone up in the sky without a Polar Pro ND filter on there, mate. Not sponsored, but these people, the best. All I have to do is whack an ND16 on this thing, and then I can send it up into the sky. I can whack my aperture on 2.8 when the sun is actually below the horizon, when it's really dark. And as the sun creeps up over the horizon and the scene gets really, really bright, I can then just adjust my exposure down to F11 to make sure that I can maintain the perfect exposure with a 1/50th of a second shutter speed. That for me was such a big thing, because every time I had the DJI Mavic Air, I'd have to bring it in, change the ND filter, send it up, change the ND filter, and it was just a bit of a nightmare. I couldn't really spend the time getting the shot that I wanted, whereas with this thing, mate, you know you're nailing your exposure because you've got such a variety of range to shoot with this thing. Next up, the battery life, mate. The battery life on the DJI Mavic Air, dead. So bad, mate. I was literally flying for about 12-15 minutes. It dies, mate. Yes, it's tiny, and yes, I knew that the DJI Mavic 2 Pro's batteries were a lot bigger, and I knew that they were going to be better, but I didn't just realise just how much better they actually were until you fly them both together. I was changing my batteries twice every time Mike was changing his once. If you're in the sky for longer, you're going to get the better shot. You're going to get the shot that you can actually spend the time composing, exposing for. Man, it's worth it. And lastly, mate, the sound. The sound of the DJI Mavic Air was just disgusting, basically. The props were really, really small, and it give off like a really high-pitched sound, like you're like being swarmed by a load of bees. Yeah, and I'm thinking, nah, this sounds dodgy. These props are really, really long, and it's like a low humming noise when this thing flies. So yeah, the noise just really got on my nerves. If anything, it just pissed me off a lot. So now, I'll be honest, people, I think there's a lesson to learn here. Don't just look at the specs of equipment without actually using it practically in the field, because you never know whether that piece of gear is going to be perfect for you. Don't get me wrong, the DJI Mavic Air is a great, great drone. The image quality is beautiful. It's tiny, it's portable. You can kind of take it anywhere without it being like a big bulk in your bag. But for me, I need to be getting close to my subjects. I need the range, the battery life. I need the exposure change. And man, I didn't even realize until I actually used this drone. Yeah. Another thing, don't listen to me. Don't listen to me about gear without actually trying it yourself. I don't want my viewers, especially you lot, to go out there and buy something just because I've said it's cool. Like, I don't want you lot to buy something that isn't probably going to be right for you. So, yeah, man. Anyway, people, I thought that this little drone update was needed because my opinions have completely changed on that topic. So I thought I needed to tell you. Anyway, this drone's sick. Hope you enjoyed this video. We've got some decent things coming. That's kind of it, mate. Oh, thanks for the 50k, you lot. You lot are sick, mate. 50,000 people. That's a lot of people. But anyway, the show goes on. We go again. And I'll be catching you lot in the next video, mate. Peace.